Hi everybody, welcome to install and configure SharePoint Farm video series. I am Hamad Sbeh. In this video I will be showing how configure user profile and my site. Okay, let's start. The first step is creating a new service account in Active Directory, one for user profile service and one for my site application pool. Next step, we need to go to SharePoint application server to register this account as a managed account in SharePoint through PowerShell. Next, we need to go back to domain controller server to give the user profile account the required permission. We need to give him replicating directory changes permission. Next step, we need to go back to SharePoint application server, and through central administration we need to create a new user profile service application. We need to fill the name, application pool name, and select user account. We notice the service is running on the application server and web front end server. Now we need to configure the service application. In this demo, I need to using SharePoint Active Directory import. I need to configure user profile connection. I need to define the connection name, type and connection string, and select the container. I need to map work email property in the user profile to mail property in Active Directory. Now we need to start the user profile synchronization. After complete the user profile synchronization, we need to make sure all user profile properties are filled. Now we need to start to preparing my site. The first step is creating a new web application for my site. Now I need to define the port and host header. The host header are creating in the global DNS server in GoDaddy in the previous demo. Next, I need to create a site collection from my site host template. Thank you. Next, I need to enable self-service site creation. And add personal as a managed path. After that, I need to define my site host URL in the user profile service. I need to test my site by another user by using MSBH user. My site is open now. I need to wait some time until preparing my site. Now my site is ready now. You can start using newsfeed, OneDrive. finally, we need to configure the OneDrive for Business to apply modern user experience. You can apply that from PowerShell. Now, the OneDrive is using the new user experience. Thank you.